By faith we see the hand of God. In the light of creation's grand design. In the lives of those who prove his faithfulness. Who walk by faith and not by sight.
Good morning. It's Wednesday. Thanks for being with us. Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. I'm Clint Davis, the pastor. Thank you for being with us. We read the Bible and we discuss it. We continue in our reading of the book of Acts, Acts chapter 10. Peter has a vision. Interestingly, Peter has this vision as he is preparing to go and speak to Cornelius. Verse 9 of Acts chapter 10. The next day, as they were on their journey, we read this yesterday, as the men from Cornelius, a God-fearing Gentile, a Roman centurion, they had come to get Peter to go and meet with their master, Cornelius. The next day, as they, those men, were on their way and on their journey and approaching the city of Joppa, Peter went up on a housetop about the sixth hour to pray. And he became hungry and wanted something to eat. But while they were preparing it, he fell into a trance and saw the heavens open and something like a great sheet descending, being let down by its four corners upon the earth. In it were all kinds of animals and reptiles and birds of the air. And there came a voice to him, "Rise, Peter, kill and eat." But Peter said, "By no means, Lord, for I have never eaten anything that is common or unclean." And the voice came to him a second time, "What God has made clean, do not call common." And this happened three times. And the thing was taken up to heaven at once. Now, Peter, while he was having this vision, he was inwardly perplexed as to what the vision had actually meant. Behold, the men who were sent by Cornelius, having made inquiry for Simon's house, stood at the gate and called out to ask whether Simon, who was called Peter, was lodging there. And while Peter was pondering the vision, the Spirit said to him, "Behold, three men are looking for you. Rise and go down and accompany them without hesitation, for I have sent them." And Peter went down to the men and said, "I am the one you were looking for. What is the reason for your coming?" And they said, "Cornelius, a centurion, an upright and God-fearing man, who was well spoken of by the whole Jewish nation, was directed by a holy angel to send for you to come to his house and to hear what you have to say. So he invited them to be his guest. The next day he arose and went with them, and some of the brothers from Joppa accompanied him. And on the following day they entered Caesarea. Cornelius was expecting them and had called together his relatives and close friends. Now, when Peter entered, Cornelius met him and fell down at his feet and worshipped him. But Peter lifted him up, saying, "Stand up, for I too am a man." And as he talked with him, he went in and found many persons gathered. And he said to them, "You yourselves know how unlawful it is for a Jew to associate with or to visit anyone of another nation. But God has shown me that I should not call any person common or unclean. So when I was sent for, I came without objection. I asked then why you sent for me." Great story. The vision, I love the vision, by the way, because the vision talks about, that Peter has on the rooftop, talks about rise, killing, and eating animals of all kinds. You know what was one of those unclean common animals that they couldn't eat? Pork. And as a good Southern American from North Carolina and now living in South Carolina, you know what I love? Barbecue. I love barbecue. And let me just tell you, it needs to have some vinegar in that sauce. Don't give me that straight tomato stuff. I need some vinegar in that sauce. And I really like that mustard sauce of South Carolina because it's got that vinegary, tangy to it, but also that sweetness. But we love barbecue. But you know what? If we had been Jews in Peter's day, we couldn't eat it. But we like that vision because it allows us to eat pig and barbecue, etc., and all these different animals. And it opens up the opens up all kinds of different options to our palates. But the reality of the vision was it wasn't just about animals and what you eat. In fact, Peter tells us later on as he goes to stand before Cornelius that I, as a Jew, should not be standing in your presence. I should not be hanging out in your house. I should not be with all of you Gentiles. It's unlawful for me to do this. It is uncommon for me to do this. I can't even associate with you. I'm not supposed to be here. But verse 28 tells us, God has shown to me that I should not call any person common or unclean. So the vision that God gave Peter was to prepare Peter's heart and prepare Peter's mind to go and speak the truth of Jesus to Cornelius. It was also a groundbreaking moment in the life of Peter, who by his own admission had become kind of the leader, and by God, the Lord Jesus' direction, had become the leader of the apostles. Now, we know Paul was already out proclaiming the good news of the gospel to the Gentiles. We read that last week, and Barnabas is testifying that to that before the brothers in Jerusalem. Now, Peter, one of their own, who had walked with Jesus, is testifying to the goodness of Christ to the Gentiles. We see God bringing together his peoples, those whom he would call by his name through Christ Jesus, to make them sons and daughters of Abraham. As Paul would later write in Galatians chapter 3, there's neither Jew nor Greek, slave nor free, male nor female, for we are all one in the Lord Jesus Christ. Not that we lose those human distinctions, but we don't have those human distinctions that are barriers when it comes to Christ. We place our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. We're one people in Christ. And we see that taking place here. The vision was to teach Peter that all people are made in the image of God, and that there is not one person that is common or unclean, for God has made them in the image of his holy name. Man, that's a wonderful encouragement for you and me today. Do you see each other that way? Do you see other people that way? Do you look down your noses at other people because you may think that they're unclean, or maybe they're too sinful, or maybe they don't know the truth and they don't know what you know. They don't have your experiences, and so maybe you don't interact with them, or maybe you feel weird around them. But Peter, I mean, you couldn't find a better distinction here, a greater distinction than a Jew who is never associated with a Gentile, never eaten any of those foods in all of his life. And Jesus says to him in a vision, God says to him in a vision, hey, look, I've made it all clean through Christ Jesus, my Lord, your Lord, through Christ Jesus, your Lord, Peter. And so that's an important thing for you and I to understand, or you and me to understand. God has made all things clean in Christ, and we are to go forward and seek to be agents of redemption by sharing the good news of Christ. We're made in the image of Jesus. We're made in the image of God. Let's go forward and share the good news of Christ with others. Have a great day. God bless you. I shall see you tomorrow here on the radio. Take care.